What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about how to deploy Windows 10 version 21H1 within SCCM 2103, because that's what I am using right now within my lab. So let's get right into it. Okay, so within your SCCM server, the first thing that we need to do is check and make sure you are running the latest and greatest Windows ADK. I think the latest one is 19.041. So make sure you have that particular Windows ADK installed within your SCCM. Now, you need to download Windows 10 21H1 ISO. Once you have downloaded that file, we need to right-click on it and then mount it. And you're going to see all the files inside that ISO. Now, I'm going to take all these files and drag them and drop them into this particular network folder. And once that's done, we are going to open up our SCCM console. Now, from here, we are going to go inside software. We're going to expand the operating system node, right-click on operating system images, and we are going to pick add operating system image. We're going to click on browse, and we're going to go inside that network path of where we drop those 21H1 files into. We need to locate the image.win file, and that file is actually located inside sources. So select it and click on open. I am going to check extract the specific image index from this specific WIM file. Then click on the drop-down menu and pick your flavor. For me, I am going to pick number 3. Now the next option is pick whether you're going to deploy 86 or 64-bit. For me, I am going to pick 64-bit. For language, click on the drop-down menu and pick your language. For me, it was English. Then click on next. Name, version, and comment. This is really up to you, so fill it in and then click on next. You're going to get a nice little summary and then click on next and then all green check marks, which is always a good thing. Click on close. Now from here, we're going to select our new image. We're going to right click on it and we need to distribute the content. So let's click on distribute the content. You're going to get the nice little wizard. Click on next. We're going to click on the add drop down menu and then we're going to pick distribution point. Pick your DP. Once you pick your DP, click OK. And then once you're done, click on next, next again, and green check mark, okay? And then click on close. Now for me, I like to wait before I proceed. And the reason why is because if you go to the lower part of your console, you're going to see the status of in progress. I like to wait until it's green, which means success. Once it's green, that means I'm able to continue, which is a good thing. And the next thing that we need to do is go inside task sequences. We're going to right click on the node and click on create task sequence. We're going to leave the default, which is install an existing image package. Click on next. You're going to provide a task sequence name, then click on browse. And then from here, pick your boot image. Once you pick your boot image, click on next. And it's time for us to pick our Windows operating system. So click on browse. And then pick that operating system that we imported inside the operating system image node, which was Windows 10 Enterprise X64 21H, right? And then click OK. And then from here, I like to check off enable the account and specify a local administrative password, enter a password, confirm it, and then from the other options, make modifications that would fit your environment. For me, I uncheck configure task sequence for BitLocker. But again, it really depends on your environment. Once you make all these changes in this particular dialog box, click on next. If you want to join a work group or a domain, configure it here. Once you're done, click on next. By default, your configuration manager client should be configured depending on your SCCM settings. If it's already pre-configured, just click next here. If you are doing any state migration, make sure you configure it here. Once you're done, click on next. If you're including any Windows updates, again, it's really up to you. I can't really tell you, okay, this is what you need to do. You gotta configure it so it can fit your environment. Once you set this up, click on next. If you're installing applications during the deployment time, add the applications in here. Once you're done, click on next. You got a nice little summary. Next again, green check marks, and then close it. Awesome. Now, the next step that we need to do is right click on our new task sequence and we need to deploy it. We're going to click on browse to pick a collection. You're going to get a nice little warning, so don't freak out. Just click OK and then pick your collection. Now, for my lab, And I'm pushing this out with new machines that are coming into my network. So I'm going to pick all unknown computers, then click OK, and then click next here. Again, this is really up to you, but for me, I'm going to hit the drop-down menu to configure it to only Media and Pixie, okay? And then click next here, schedule it. Once you configure the scheduling, click next. User experience, again, this is up to you. I left everything as the default, and then click next again. Alerts, left everything as the default, click next. And for the DP settings, I left everything as the default and just click next again. Nice little summary, next, and then close it. And that's it. Now, at the end of the video, you're going to see like a speed through of the actual task sequence that we created together and doing everything live and actually deploying that task sequence with that operating system to a virtual machine, successfully doing it with no problem. And that's it. Hopefully, you guys enjoyed this video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.